Hey everybody, this is Mad Matt Carter. Thank you so much for watching the AIWF Network YouTube channel, as well as the AIWF Ringside Wrestling channel. If you like what you see, please do us a big favor. Hit that like button, hit subscribe, and ring that bell to get notifications every time we post new videos on both our channels. It means a lot to us, and thanks a lot for watching once again.
Is always a great day for pro wrestling, and we have a whole lot of it coming up here this evening. Tonight, we got the BCW Heavyweight Championship up for grabs, and Rocking Ball here tonight is here to challenge the champion, B.D. Cruz. Yes. Plus, we got three tag team qualifier matches for the BCW Tag Team Championship. Plus, we have the Palm USA
gentlemen, as my broadcast partner, the professor, indicated, we are live at Bay State Championship Wrestling for an afternoon of fun-filled matches, professor, to say the least. Starting off, we have The Mission, led by Dan the Man and Stan Michael, facing off against the Outback Attack, comprised of Gibbs and The Wonder from Down Under, Alan Compass.
It should be a most exciting matchup to get us started here this evening.
And the man in charge is Miggy Stripes.
This is a packed arena here in Holyoke, Massachusetts. I believe that it's going to be Alan Compass starting off here today. And Dan the Man, the legend that is Dan the Man, been around for quite a few years.
Dan has definitely been well-traveled on the pro wrestling circuit.
Miggy Stripes calling for the bell there. And of course, Dan has a few words to say.
Dan trying to get everybody to join The Mission.
Of course, trying to get, like you said, everybody to join The Mission. He's had quite a few questionable tactics and questionable words over the last few years.
Yeah, Dan not a favorite with the fans, that's for sure. Alan getting the crowd get with the Aussie, Aussie, Aussie chant.
Stand up and share!
Is he talking to us?
We're just the announce team. He's definitely barking up the wrong tree there, Professor, if he's looking to get me to stand up for him. Looks like we're finally ready for a lockup here, Professor.
Look at this. All right, there's a tag already to Stan Mica. He's going to put him in against. I think he looks a little surprised.
Yeah, Stan Mica looks to be a little confused. Well, apparently, Professor, we're going to have a bath of some sort, as Stan Mica says he's going to wash Alan Compass's dirty posterior. We'll keep this family-friendly, Professor.
This is a family-friendly show. Collar and elbow tie up there, and of course, you know, there is a considerable size difference between Alan Compass and Stan Mica, so he shoved him down with relative ease.
Yeah, that was not a challenge for Alan at all. Here comes Stan again, throwing in the fist into the ropes.
There's a roll-up. Can Alan get him here? Nope. Oh, Michael
reversed.
Rolls through. Nice arm drag right there, deep, and he forced him down very strongly.
Deep pull-down arm drag. I think Michaels is regretting his choice of words earlier. Alan firmly in control right now.
He's working his way up. He's going to try to work his way out of it, backing Alan Compass up against the ropes.
Will we get a clean break? I didn't think so, Professor.
I didn't really think so. Come on, Alan. Alan firing back now. He shoves Michael off. Went for a hip toss. It looks like he got a little bit stuck there on the way.
Shoulder tackle by Stan Michael.
That
and
was pretty impressive for a guy his size.
Yeah, and he's just standing there now like... Oh, he just said it's all about your mom instead of the mission.
Nice leapfrog. We got him that time with a hip toss. Slams him down hard in the center of the ring, and he goes immediately over and tags Dan the Man, and he does not look pleased.
Yeah, Dan the Man, I don't think wanted to come in.
Charges right there, and Alan Compass walks right into that inverted atomic drop. Gets thrown right into the corner. It looks like maybe Gibbs is going to tag in. Yes.
Oh, and here comes Gibbs. And let me tell you something. Gibbs is a bit of a powerhouse. Flinging Compass into Dan the Man. European uppercut.
Now Gibbs going with the no gimmick Gibbs. He's basically rebooted himself in a way. He's been quite impressive over the last couple months during this time.
Yes, absolutely, Professor. He's been definitely on the go. Uh-oh, they're up to something here.
I want to see what they're going for here.
Well, here's an interesting rope. Oh, that was a rather interesting play right there. Dan the Man basically falling in our laps. Alan tosses the back. Oh, but Michael with a big scissor kick to the back of the head.
He just got thrown.
Compass into the ring post. Meanwhile, the action continues in the ring.
Up and over by Dan the Man. He's going to pull this up to the top. Gibbs caught him. And a power slam off
that
top rope.
He just threw him halfway across the ring, Professor.
I don't think that it was going to take that easy to get Dan the Man down. He's going to have to go through a lot more to pin him.
Only a count of two, and of course, Miggy strikes with that distinctive two call.
And the most experienced referees here in the northeastern part of the United States. Whoa!
Oh!
Over there, that Enziguri kick by Stan Michael as went to the corner in a neck breaker right there by Dan the Man.
Like him or not, you got to admit that was great tag team wrestling right there.
Now Michael coming in. He's going to be going after something off the ropes.
Big leg drop.
I think Stan Michaels a little bit too light. He doesn't have enough weight to sit on top of Gibbs' chest. Pump is still recovering, making his way up the apron. And he's got him in a reverse chin lock here, trying to wear him down, restrict the breath. But does Michael have enough weight to lay on top of Gibbs like that, trying to wear him down?
You know, I think a strong wind could send Stan Michael into the next county. But he isn't a what a tremendous move that was, Professor.
That would be made famous by Billy Gardner, famouser in a super kick, cheap shot on Alan Compass.
Only good for two. As I'm sitting here disparaging Stan Michael, boy, he just put a series of moves together. Basically, he, you know, shut me up.
Look at this, he's choking him. Referee, he's got to break that hold.
Once again, Compass is down on the outside of the ring after being taken out.
Series of leg drops hit by Dan the Man, really getting in there deep. This is the experience that someone like Dan has. Look at this.
I'm not sure what that was, but it went into another leg drop. Only good for a two count.
Gibbs not going to be taken down that easy.
Another quick tag to Stan Michael.
Dan holding him off, distracting the referee by setting that up. Compass in the ring needs to get out of the ring.
Yeah, he needs to step out. As I said, Professor, we may not like them, but they are working like a well-oiled machine right now, the mission is.
See what they're going here. Looks like a heart attack. Going for the cover now.
Powerful kick out by Gibbs.
Gibbs has a lot more fight in him, I believe. It's not going to take him that easy. Michael taunting Alan Compass. The more that he does that, it's more of an advantage to the mission because he's getting the referee distracted by setting up Compass.
Alan is taking Miggy Stripes. He's actually creating a distraction, allowing the mission to continue their double teaming.
He's taking him to his corner. There's the tag there. Dan the Man coming back in here.
Oh, I think that's the first legal tag in about 4 minutes.
And that chop ringing through the arena here in Holyoke, Massachusetts. A running knee. What's Michael going for? He goes for the cover once again. Gibbs
still
says
Gibbs
no.
Gets out. A lot of fight in Gibbs. Michael trying to pull. European uppercut. They have Gibbs staggering in the corner.
And he's just working on Gibbs there. Here comes to the corner. Gibbs throws him over. Surprisingly, Gibbs got a little breath there.
What's Michael doing in the corner there?
Off the ropes. Oh, Gibbs caught him.
Oh, what a power move by Gibbs.
Wow. Does Gibbs have enough to make it to the corner and tag in Alan Compass?
The crowd is on the edge of their seats trying to get Gibbs to go.
Gibbs, that might have taken the last of the energy out of Gibbs, but he looks like he is struggling to get up. He's moving very slowly. Michael looks like he made it to his corner. He's about to tag in Dan the Man.
Michaels makes the tag. Oh!
And the hot
Gibbs
tag there.
Make the tag.
Shoulder Alan tackles.
Pippins. Dropping elbows. Shoulder tackles.
There's like a low blockbuster there, it looks like. He's going for the Aussie roll.
This is the alligator roll.
The alligator roll, excuse me.
I'm sorry, the crocodile roll. Wrong country there I was in for a moment, Professor.
That was a big suplex right there in the center of the ring.
Nice vertical suplex by Compass. He is in control at the moment. He's calling for something.
It was a Vader bomb.
Oh, almost a three count.
Dan able to get that right shoulder out of there. I think it's going to take a little bit more to beat the veteran like that.
A little surprised, an early tag. I don't think Gibbs has really recovered yet. Well, I stand corrected. That was one heck of a move and a lot of power. But we got Michael in the ring again.
Watch out. Michael breaks that up. I don't think that they were quite ready for that. This match is all over the place now. Literally.
I forget what it is that Alan called that particular move. But again, the veteran, Dan the Man. Oh, no. Gibbs reverses.
A stunner there by Zachariah Gibbs, going for the cover on Dan. Michael once again able to get in there and break that up.
Stan Michaels still talking some smack there, Professor. Oh, wait a minute.
Gibbs caught him. He looked like he was going for a power slam.
Oh, and another cutter. Another stunner.
He really nailed him, and he just about rolled out of the ring, excuse me. You gotta watch out. Dan looks like he's got something. The referee can't see it. His back is to Michael, checking on Michael.
Oh, it's the mission book.
Right across the chin. He nailed him with his own cutter.
He hit him with the mission book. Oh, come on. It can't end this way, Professor.
Unbelievable.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this tag team qualifier match, the team of Stan Michael and Dan the Man, the Mission.
Well, a well-fought battle by the Outback Attack, but the veteran just had too many tricks up his sleeve.
Unbelievable. What a disgusting victory by the Mission.
Not that we would expect anything different, Professor, and that's sad, because you know Dan the Man has the ability, but he chooses to act this way.
Chooses to take shortcut after shortcut, and he's a more than capable commander. The Mission victorious once again.
Number one fans, Josh down there,
don't think it's ever smart in a tag team match when you guys. A couple of these
buff and the stuff. I see the stuff, but I'm not sure about the buff.
These guys just love wasting time now, don't they?
The referee is trying to check two buff, and now the buff dad seems upset that he wasn't checked.
What is going on here?
Ref Orlando wanted nothing to do with that.
Everybody knows you two aren't even friends. Every time you've had together, you've shown up. So what is the point? Winner!
Deloro just, did he just smack two buff? Oh, there's a drop kick spending Buff Dad out of the ring. It looks like it. I don't know who's going to start
Stevie
this.
Legend. He's just stalking.
I mean, that's a little creepy by a legend.
It's like the what a forearm shiver that was. He's putting all his weight behind that.
Referee needs to get control. Maybe kicking the legend out of the ring.
Finally, Ref Orlando gets Stevie Legend out.
Big suplex right here in the center of the ring by Deloro. Two buff kicks out of there. Gets that right shoulder up. Too early in the match for that.
Goes into an arm bar. Not happy. Stevie Legend tags in. That'll get the crowd going.
I'm sure it will. There we go. With a double hip toss. Look at that brutal elbow there by Stevie Legend.
Two buffs still kicking up.
There's a rake of the eyes by Two Buff. And what? Legend backed up Two Buff, and Buff Dad went flying off the apron. Stevie throws him over the top rope.
This is not like a battle royal or a royal rumble where over the top gets you a victory, though, Stevie.
Whoa, look at that. He
leaped over the rope.
I think
into
he
two buff.
Judged that a little short.
Ref Orlando has kind of lost control. Oh! And Stevie Legend just clotheslined
his own partner
in the back.
Oh, Buff Dad just nailed Legend with something, with a right fist. Was there something in that fist? Legend able to kick out.
And then another two count. Two Buff getting a little upset with only getting a two count. El Nino Del Oro just chomping at the bit, waiting to get in, looking for a tag.
He's just putting all his weight across the throat
right
with his knee.
Yeah, right across the throat, Professor. I mean, this is...
You can't choke a legend.
And I have to say, though, again... The tag teams are keeping the referee distracted.
5 minutes remaining. 5 minutes remaining.
We've just been informed there's only 5 minutes left in this match.
Ten-minute time limit, I believe. It looks like Tupac and Legend are going at it. They're struggling to get ahead here. Oh, it looks like... Legend,
that's the second time Stevie Legend has hit El Nino Del Oro.
Tubuff just threw him hard into that corner. Buff Dad in there now, just ramming his shoulder through Stevie Legend. Tubuff taunting El Nino.
Running forearm into the corner. Stevie is collapsed in the corner.
Tubuff just stomping a mud hole in.
Lay in the boots to him, Professor.
And he's going to, look at that. El Nino looks, said that he was going to pop him. I don't know how amazing that was. I mean,
Tubuff touting his own legend, if you will. Not Stevie Legend, just his own legend.
Nino trying to get the crowd going here to get Stevie lipped up. There's a jawbreaker. There's a tag. Clothesline on Buff Dad.
That drove him into the corner. Spinning back elbow.
He's measuring him. There's a nice drop kick. He got some good height on that one. And a stinger splash in the corner.
Double noggin knocker.
Got him up. He just nailed him right there. Legend.
And Stevie just tagged himself in.
El Nino doesn't like it. He looks like he was arguing with about it.
Yeah, I mean, they don't seem to be on the same page, Professor. I mean, Stevie Legend is actually, albeit via accident. And now Stevie's not sure where he's going. He's going to the corner. He's going up. Going up top. Apparently he's going to fly, but the Buff Dad.
Well, hold on. Sean P. Jacobs have something to do with this?
What was up with that?
El Nino came in there and tagged himself back in. I'm confused as to what is going on here with this team.
They are definitely. With the megaphone.
Hold on. Referee did not see it.
Buff Inc. are your winners.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this matchup and attacking qualifier, the team of Tubuff and Buff Dad, Buff Inc.
And an ever so impressive win.
Just super kicked his partner, Stevie Legend.
I will tell you, Professor, I do have a little bit of inside information through my sources that Stevie feels that El Nino del Oro, because of the mask, is on the dark side. And he's trying to get him back to see the
Secondhand Heroes and Home for Wayward Villains is a comic book shop and gaming store that also features Magic the Gathering and D&D. Located at 18184 Leesville Road in Evington, Virginia, Secondhand Heroes is your one-stop shop for you to get your nerd on. Open 7 days a week at 11 a.m., they don't close until the dice stop rolling. They buy, sell, trade, barter, and haggle, specializing in collectible toys, both vintage and modern, comics, Magic the Gathering, video games, console, and arcade cabinets to play, all set to free play. Host your game night with us. Monday night D&D video game competitions, and so much more. Something for the collector and gamer in us all. Call 434-317-0121 or shoot us an email with any questions to secondhandheroesva@gmail.com. Note, secondhandheroesva@gmail.com, that's 2ND, handheroesva@gmail.com. Come game with us.
So Yeah. other way. We take them out that way. That way.
This way. I'll come to every show. All y'all better watch out back. Yeah. All y'all.
You can tell it to the
show. Okay.
Get the door.
Lewis, I'm coming. I don't give a damn. I'm coming back. I swear to God, I'm coming back. I don't care what show it is. I'll be there.
You're not going to be here tonight. All right, you guys lock it down. I'll be right back.
All right.